In this video, I'm going to complete numbers 5 through 8 on the Work Word Problems worksheet under the Infinite Algebra 2 tab on the CUDA software website. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this. Now I'm going to mix it up and I'm going to do numbers 7 and 8 before I do numbers 5 through 6 because I believe numbers 7 and 8 are significantly easier to understand and they're very similar to numbers 1 through 4, which we've already completed. So let's go down to number 7 and get started. In number 7, it says that a diesel train made a trip to the repair yards and back. The trip there took 15 hours, so 15 hours total to get there, and the trip back took 18 hours, so 18 hours total to get back. What was the diesel train's average speed on the trip there if it averaged 35 kilometers per hour on the return trip? So we're trying to find the train's average speed, and since this is our unknown, this can be our variable, and let's make that variable y. So the average speed of the train, y, we're going to multiply that by the time it took to get there, because we don't know the average speed of the time it took to get there. So we're taking y and multiplying that by 15 hours. That's going to be equal to the average speed of the return trip, 35 kilometers per hour, times the amount of time the trip back took, which was 18 hours. So we have y times 15 hours, and that's going to be equal to the total distance of a single length of the trip. So 35 kilometers per hour times 18 hours is going to equal 630 kilometers. You can almost think of the label hours canceling out. 35 kilometers times 18 is 630 kilometers. Our next step, we're going to divide by 15 hours. In doing this, we'll isolate our variable y, which is the average speed of the trip there. So the return trip and back are equal distances. The return trip was a total distance of 630 kilometers, so the trip there was also 630 kilometers. And if it took the train 15 hours to travel 630 kilometers, we can find the average speed. We'll take 630 and divide that by 15 to get 42, and that's going to be kilometers per hour. So 42 kilometers per hour is our solution in number 7. Continuing on to number 8, it says that Shayna left home and traveled toward the ferry office. She traveled towards the ferry office at an average speed of 40 miles per hour. Sometime later, Mary left traveling in the same direction, but at an average speed of 50 miles per hour. After traveling for 4 hours, Mary caught up with Shayna. Find the number of hours Shayna traveled before Mary caught up. So we know that Mary traveled an average of 50 miles per hour, and she traveled that for 4 hours, and that's when she finally caught up to Shayna. So Mary traveled 50 miles per hour, and she traveled for 4 hours total, and that's when she finally caught up with Shayna. Shayna, we know, traveled an average speed of 40 miles per hour, but we don't know how long she traveled for. So that's going to be our variable. Let's call this variable z. 50 miles per hour times 4 hours is 200 miles. So we know that Mary traveled a total distance of 200 miles before she caught up with Shayna. And we have that Shayna traveled 40 miles per hour for some time z. And if the total distance was 200 miles, we can divide both sides by 40 miles per hour to get the total time that it took Shayna to travel, which was z. So 200 miles total divided by 40 miles per hour gives us a total of 5 hours. So if Shayna traveled for 5 hours at 40 miles per hour and Mary traveled for 4 hours at 50 miles per hour. Now let's go back up and complete numbers 5 and 6. Let's start with number 6. It says a diesel train left Washington and traveled toward Johannesburg at an average speed of 52 miles per hour. A cattle train left 2 hours later and traveled in the same direction but with an average speed of 60 miles per hour. So we have to find the number of hours the diesel train traveled before the cattle train had caught up. So the diesel train was traveling at a speed of 52 miles per hour. And we're trying to find the number of hours the diesel train traveled total. So let's make our variable x. And that's going to be equal to the speed of the cattle train, 60 miles per hour. However, the cattle train we know left 2 hours later, so it traveled 2 hours less than the total time that the diesel train traveled. So if our diesel train traveled a total of X hours, then our cattle train leaving 2 hours later traveled a total of X minus 2 hours. So this 60 miles per hour is going to be multiplied to X minus 2. So let's go ahead and distribute that 60. 60 will get multiplied to X and will get multiplied to 2. So we have 52 miles per hour. We're multiplying that by X, and that's going to be equal to 60 miles per hour times X minus, since there's subtraction in between the terms, 60 miles per hour times 2, which is 120. So we have that 52x equals 60x minus 120. So what I'm going to do is subtract 60x from both sides. 52x minus 60x results in a negative 8x, and that's equal to 60x minus 60x, which is 0, and we're subtracting 120, so that's going to be equal to negative 120. When we divide both sides by negative 8, we'll get that x, and that's going to be equal to positive 15. So the diesel train traveled 15 hours before the cattle train caught up. And since the cattle train left 2 hours later, that means that the cattle train traveled a total of 13 hours. But what we were looking for was the number of hours the diesel train traveled, and that was 15. Now, finally, we're going to do number 5. Number 5 says a jet left Paris at the same time as a passenger plane. The planes flew in opposite directions. So we have one plane going this way and another plane going that way. So opposite directions. So let's have the jet plane fly to the left and the passenger plane P can be flying to the right. So the passenger plane flew at a speed of 450 miles per hour. After 11 hours, they were 9,460 miles apart. So we're trying to figure out how fast the jet flew. In order to do that, we're going to have to take the total distance, which the total distance between those is 9,460 miles, and we're going to have to figure out how far the passenger plane flew, which we will be able to figure out knowing its speed and how long it traveled. And once we subtract that from the total distance, we can use how long they both traveled, so the jet also traveled 11 hours, to find out its average speed. So the passenger plane flew at 450 miles per hour, and it flew a total of 11 hours. So when we multiply 450 by 11, we get a total of 4,950 miles. That's how far the passenger plane flew. So their total distance is 9,460 miles apart. I'm going to take that total distance, 9,460 miles, and I'm going to subtract 4,950 miles to get the total distance that the jet flew, which 9,460 minus 4,950 will be 4,510 miles. So 4,510 is the total distance that the jet flew. And we knew that the jet flew for 11 hours. So the average speed, X, of the jet will be equal to the total distance that the jet flew, 4,510 miles, divided by how long it flew, which was 11 hours. So if it traveled 4,510 miles in 11 hours, the average speed is 4,510 divided by 11, which is 410 miles per hour. So the jet flew 410 miles per hour. So with the jet flying 410 miles per hour and the passenger plane flying 450 miles per hour, both of them flying that speed for 11 hours, they were 9,460 miles apart. We looked at the problem as three different parts: the total distance, the total distance of the passenger plane, and the total distance of the jet plane. However, we can look at this as a single equation. The total distance the jet travels plus the total distance that the passenger plane traveled equals 9,460 miles. So if the passenger plane flew 450 miles per hour for 11 hours, we'll have 450 miles per hour times 11 hours. If we add that distance, since that will give us distance, to the speed of the jet, which we said was x, times the total time that traveled, which is also 11 hours, that would give us 9,460 miles total. So 450 times 11 we got was 4,950. Then we subtracted that quantity from this side of the equation to get that x times 11 hours was equal to 4,510, this step. And then eventually we divided by 11 to get that x was equal to 410. And with that, we complete problem numbers 5 through 8. Join me in the next video where I'll finish out this work words problem worksheet, completing numbers 9 through 12. Also, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and give me a thumbs up if you like this video. If you have any comments, please leave it in the comment section below.